We're preparing for an interview, and the panel suddenly throws the phrase, "Tell us how you'd secure our APIs." Your mind goes blank. If that sounds familiar, don't worry. You're in the right place. In this video, we're diving into 20 powerful API security interview questions and answers, from foundational concepts to real-world implementation strategies. Whether you're just starting out or have years of experience, these questions could be the edge you need to impress any interviewer. So grab your notes, stay tuned till the end, and let's get into it. Let's start with something basic but critical. What is API security, and why is it so important today? API security is about protecting APIs from threats such as unauthorized access, data leaks, or abuse. With APIs acting as bridges between services, users, and data, a single vulnerability can expose entire systems. As more businesses shift to microservices and mobile-first approaches, APIs become both essential and vulnerable. That's why ensuring their security isn't just a technical task, it's a business imperative. Next question. How do authentication and authorization differ when it comes to securing APIs? Authentication is the process of confirming who you are. Authorization, on the other hand, is about determining what you're allowed to do. For example, when you log into a system, you're authenticated. But when you try to access a restricted resource, your authorization decides if you can proceed. APIs use this distinction to control access and prevent misuse. Next question. What are some of the most common API authentication methods used today? The most common ones include API keys, OAuth 2.0, JWTS, and Mutual TLS. API keys are simple but not very secure if exposed. OAuth 2.0 allows third-party apps limited access without sharing passwords. JWTS are compact, stateless tokens often used in OAuth flows. And Mutual TLS validates both the client and server using certificates, which is great for internal service-to-service communication. Next question. Can you explain how OAuth 2.0 works in real-world API scenarios? Sure. Let's say you're using a third-party fitness app that needs access to your Google Fit data. OAuth 2.0 allows that app to request permission without asking for your Google password. Once approved, the app gets a time-limited access token from Google's authorization server. That token is then used to securely access your data without ever exposing your credentials. Next question. What role does an API gateway play in enforcing security? An API gateway acts as a gatekeeper. It centralizes authentication, rate limiting, logging, and other policies. By routing all API traffic through a gateway, you reduce the risk of inconsistencies and exposure. Think of it as the front desk security that checks everyone's ID before they access your building. It simplifies compliance and ensures all APIs follow the same set of security rules. Next question. How does rate limiting contribute to API security? Rate limiting prevents abuse by controlling how often users or systems can call your API. This protects against brute force attacks, denial of service attacks, and even accidental overuse. For instance, a free tier might allow 1,000 calls per hour. If a user exceeds that, their access is throttled. It's a smart way to preserve resources and maintain service quality. Next question. How would you secure sensitive data in API requests and responses? Always use HTTPS to encrypt data in transit. Never expose credentials, tokens, or personal information in URLs or logs. You can also encrypt specific fields in the payload or use tokenization. Input validation is another key strategy. Sanitize everything coming into the system. And finally, follow the principle of least privilege, granting access to only what's necessary. Next question. What is CORS and how does it impact API security? CORS, or cross-origin resource sharing, is a browser feature that restricts how web pages from different domains interact. By default, browsers block cross-origin requests. With CORS, you explicitly allow certain domains to access your API. Without proper CORS settings, you could unintentionally expose data to malicious scripts running in a user's browser. Next question. What is a replay attack and how can APIs defend against it? A replay attack involves intercepting a valid request and resending it to perform the same action again. For example, resending a money transfer request. To prevent this, APIs often use nonces, unique, one-time tokens, and timestamps. If the server detects the same token or an outdated timestamp, it rejects the request. This adds a temporal layer of protection. Next question, how do JSON Web Tokens, JWT, help in securing APIs? JWTs are compact tokens that carry encoded information like user ID and permissions. They're signed by the server and can be verified without calling a database. This makes authentication faster and scalable. However, JWTs must be stored securely and set to expire quickly to prevent misuse. Also, never trust the content blindly. Always validate the signature. Let's turn things up a bit. Next question. What is the difference between open, internal, and partner APIs from a security perspective? Open APIs are available to anyone, so they need strong public-facing protections like rate limiting and robust authentication. Internal APIs are used within an organization and may have more trust, but still require strict access controls. Partner APIs are shared with specific third parties and usually involve contracts, stricter policies, and IP whitelisting to prevent abuse. Next question. How do you handle third-party dependencies in API security? Always audit and monitor third-party libraries or SDKs. Just because you trust a vendor doesn't mean their code is secure. Use tools like dependency scanners to detect known vulnerabilities. Also, pin specific versions and monitor them for updates. Your API is only as strong as its weakest dependency. Next question. How can you protect APIs against injection attacks? Validate and sanitize all incoming data. Avoid directly embedding user inputs and queries, especially SQL or NoSQL. Use parameterized queries, input whitelisting, and strong schema validation. Attackers often inject malicious scripts or commands, so it's crucial to treat all input as untrusted. Next question. What's the importance of logging and monitoring in API security? Without logging, you're flying blind. Logging helps detect suspicious activity like brute force attempts, token abuse, or unexpected error spikes. Monitoring adds real-time insights, helping you react quickly to breaches. Use structured logs and integrate with SIEM tools to analyze patterns and trigger alerts. Next question. How does API versioning affect security? With versioning, you can isolate changes and deprecate insecure endpoints gracefully. It also helps manage backward compatibility and limits exposure to outdated logic or vulnerabilities. Never make breaking changes to a live API without a version strategy. It's both a security and stability risk. Next question. Explain the concept of least privilege in the context of API access. Least privilege means giving users or systems the minimum access needed to perform their tasks. For example, a reporting app might only need read access to a database, not write access. This limits damage if credentials are compromised. Implementing fine-grained roles and permissions supports this principle effectively. Next question. What is Mutual TLS and when should it be used? Mutual TLS is an extension of HTTPS, where both client and server authenticate each other using certificates. It's highly secure and often used for service-to-service communication in microservice environments. While it's more complex to set up, it provides strong identity assurance. Next question. What steps can you take to prevent broken object-level authorization, or BOLA? BOLA happens when users can access resources they shouldn't, by guessing or modifying object IDs. To prevent this, always enforce authorization checks on the back end. Never rely on obscurity, like assuming a user won't guess another user's ID. Use access tokens tied to user identity and verify access on every request. Next question. How would you test an API for security vulnerabilities? Use a mix of automated tools like OWASP Zap, Postman Security Scanner, or Burp Suite, along with manual testing. Check for common vulnerabilities like broken authentication, injection, misconfigurations, and insecure deserialization. Also test edge cases, rate limits, and access controls. Security testing should be part of your CI/CD pipeline. And here's our final question. How do you balance API security with performance? Security often adds overhead, like encryption, token checks, or logging. To balance it, use caching where appropriate, optimize token validation, and only log what's essential. Rate limiting and quotas help ensure fair usage without overloading servers. Ultimately, secure doesn't have to mean slow. Smart engineering can give you both. That's a wrap. You've just explored 20 essential API security interview questions designed to prepare you for real-world challenges. If you found this valuable, hit like, subscribe Topictrick, and let us know in the comments which question you'd like us to cover in more detail. Until next time, stay curious, stay secure.